एंड देन विल टेक एग्जिस्टिंग प्रेजेंट हाउ टू राइट टारगेट. तो दोनों तरीके से हो जाएगा. ओके तो राइट नाउ आई विल से 21 22 टीडीडी डेमो. And get a fresh new project. Test driven programming demo. Yep. So now. When you create this application, you have to select these two bottom checkbox. Anyone, please uncheck box. You will check. Include unit test and include UI test. Okay. Next, I select okay. Automatic signing manage off. Now see here, prior to your previous project, we used to have only one folder called project file. Now there are two targets added. You see, under targets also you have project 5 test and project 5 UI test. These are called targets. Okay. Now, so we'll write one test case for UI and one for unit test. Okay. Now, basically, unit tests are divided into two halves, logical unit test and application unit test. Logical means only functional. Your provider classes ka functionality. UI is a merger where your model meets view based on controllers. Okay, these are two basic. Initially, we used to have only one test suite where we used to write all those test cases. Nowadays, in latest Xcode, they have split it up. Kaap UI yahan likho, pure logical, udhar likho. So we have to create one dummy app, right? And then we'll test na. The coverage and everything, right? So what I'll do in my view controller, this is my screen. We'll create one function which will take an input as an integer and return a string, and that string will apply to the label. Simple. Okay, so we'll have a unit test case on the function which takes the input as integer and return a string, and we'll have a UI application text on a label update text. So both things that's covered, right? Now, so I'll say var name label. And I have to create a function get name, which takes value as input and return string. I'll say switch value is just a dummy. Done. Shall I? I'll say load. And view it out now and just shall I? So when I run this on my simulator, I am getting the whatever text for zero, I'll get Priyang, right? Okay. So depending on what you are passing, I'm getting the value, right? Now it's time for us to write the test cases, right? The unit test cases for the sale. Shall I? So now I'll start with the unit test, this one. Okay. This is a purely functional testing. Every suit will be respect to your provider or parser, depending upon your logic. Okay. It's nothing to do with your junction. In controller also, in our case, in controller only we wrote any code, right? So it's basically based on the functionality. Okay. Now, we need to create a mock object of the controller. Now, controller is under inside the target. This is inside other target. So it cannot be directly used. I cannot type view control and I'll get it. See, I'm not getting it, right? Basically, it's not detectable, right? How do you make it detectable? You click on the view controller. Everyone click on this view control file. Go open and right side window. This right side window has target membership. You see? Remember when we create a file, we always get a target. So in white label also, if you have multiple builds, you have to select them. Okay, this class, kaun se target mein accessible honi chahiye. Okay? So I want to access in all the targets. Okay? Then I can get a reference of that. Clear, everyone? Now, I'll come here. I'll say test controller. I'll say view control. Shall I? So now, okay. Now, setup is basically you initialize all your object, mock objects on which you want to do. Tear down is your release. Okay, like constructor and destructor. Okay. Now, a test function is a void function which doesn't take any parameter and a argument. the rules are same across all the platforms. It starts with the word test and then you do it. Okay. So right now I want to create a test. So I have to first set up, right, the mock object. So I'll say test controller. I'll initialize my controller. In tier down, I'll say release my controller, right? Shall I? So now, how do you write? So I want to write a test case for my get name. So I'll say func, followed by what test, and then I'll say get name function name. It's a void function, right? It should be starting with test. Now I'll say let expected. So I define an expect value as Priyank. Again. And then I'll say actual value. So you define your input and output, right? I'll say test controller dot get name zero. So you can have inputs, output, right? And now we know we need to have assert statement. Assert statement is a conditional log. Condition true goes to next line. Condition fail prints the output and stops. Similarly, all test cases use assert statement, right? So here they have overload the exit function like xcasset. Okay. And you have plenty of whether true, false, nil, not nil, true, false, equal. So I'll go for equal, right? Okay. You have a lot of options, equal maybe. So I'll say expected value, actual value. And if it fails, you can write get name fail. So you have nil, not nil, true, false, greater than, equal to. Okay, everything, those commands are available. So here I'm equating, right? Okay.
Indexing
Shall I?
Yes.
How do you run it? You have two options. You can press Command U, which will run the test case. Or you see this at a class level, you have this rhombus. You can press here it'll automatically run these entire test cases inside this test suite. First time you have to run all the test cases. After you run once, now you can run individual also. So I got test success. Okay. Now, as soon as I make it one, I can run this individual also. Okay. Build success, right? Test me, we test over.
Fail.
So I can know Priyang is not equal to Ranga. Okay. To get name failed. Now you can have an additional message also if you want to put. So here also you can come to know. See this? Get name failed. Baki to pass over. Okay. We'll see the coverage.
ऐसे कैसे इशू आते रिसाइक्लिंग कर लिया
वो इंडेक्सिंग हो रहा था फिर बंद कर दिया शायद
अभी आ गया ना
नहीं फिर से कुछ ऐसा
प्रोजेक्ट फाइव सेलेक्ट
कर ले
चले अभी से इट्स कॉल्ड टेस्ट ड्रिवन प्रोग्रामिंग राइट ओके basically it doesn't mean you have to write test cases and then write code we can write unit test cases only when we write a code so when you write a code now you might write in some life cycle methods like a beauty load map the code click get name now you expect that get name should get executed right yeah we have explicitly executed right because we made a modular code suppose you didn't have a modular code and your life cycle method will not get called during the test cases your window hierarchy is not created only Your view will appear, view will disappear, will not get called. Okay, you are just creating a reference of the object. So you have been drive to make a code changes so that your test cases can be executed. So in that process, you will learn to create modular coding. And that's the reason it's called test driven programming. You write a code, you write a test case, and then drive your code according to your test cases. Okay, a lot of people say, pehle test likhna padta hai, fir ho raha hai. Wo possible hi nahi hai. Code ke bina test cases kaise likhu? I will write some code and then I'll write test cases. In that course of writing test cases, I'll realize, oh, my code is not properly created, right? Because I cannot write a test. Then we'll try to change the code. And at that time, we say it's a test-driven programming. Okay? Everyone clear? Now, if I want to check the coverage. You go to last step. Okay, and you select the test which you built 316 code, right? Which says test failed, right? There's something called coverage, right? You have no coverage data. The coverage data means how much code was covered in this test suite. Okay, so you want to know ki bhai mera sara code cover hua hai ki nahi hua, right? And if entire code is covered,
project 5
You get this drop down. Everyone? There's another edit scheme. Everyone got this option? When you click on this edit scheme, you get this run pe kya karna hai a lot of options so you say on test I want to get a gather the coverage data. You see, there's an option. Okay. कैसे गया था प्रोजेक्ट फाइव है ये जो प्रोजेक्ट नेम मैंने क्लिक किया यू गेट दिस ऑप्शन राइट क्लिक ऑन एडिट स्कीम इन एडिट स्कीम यू क्लिक ऑन डीबग टेस्ट एवरीवन टेस्ट देयर इज एन ऑप्शन कॉल्ड गैदर कवरेज डेटा एवरीवन यस ऑफ कोर्स एंड नाउ अगेन यू हैव टू रन अ टेस्ट केस ओके सो आई गो हियर I again run this test case. Definitely I'll get an error again because it's failed, it'll come failed. Wait. Then code coverage. When I click on 325, on a coverage, I'll see. At a, no, that's on the project level. And a controller level is 70% coverage because obviously. आपके सारे स्विच केस तो जाएंगे नहीं ना सी व्यू डिड लोड और मेमोरी वार्निंग तो विल नॉट गेट कवर ओनली
वो वहां तो जाया ही नहीं वो
सो इफ दिस गिव्स यू अ ऑप्शन ना कोड कवर हुआ आपका ओके
उसमें आप चेक करो क्या हो रहा है यू सी दिस That two names, right? Project 5 test and Project 5 app. Project पहले create हुआ उसके बाद test चालू होता है, right? Project create होने का build होने का बंद हो जाता है, and then test cases start होते हैं run करने. तो हमको ये नहीं लिखना है, हमको test cases के time पे लिखने का है कि app कितना cover हुआ. Clear everyone? So when you click here, you will get these two files, right? Because we have only two files, right? View controller or टेस्ट केस यही दो हो गए टेस्ट केस यू डिड रन द टेस्ट केस आफ्टर कवरेज डेटा के साथ नहीं किया आपने हां सो वी आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन डॉट ऐप वी आर इंटरेस्टेड एक्सीड टेस्ट वाला So there, when you run this test suite, two files were compiled, view controller and see app delegate was not considered only. Now when I go to view controller, you will find load name was not called because we never went for load name ka testing, right? Neither view did load will get called because it's not lifecycle method. You just created test controller. Okay, it was not bind to a view hierarchy. If it's not bind to a view hierarchy, it won't give you view did load and all those things. I went for get name, right? In get name also it's covered. So when I double click now, it'll show you this part was not covered. Fair enough, right? Now if I put 3 instead of 1 or 2, 0, if I put 3, it will go till here, right? So this way we see the coverage, okay? But important thing to note is what? Your lifecycle methods were not covered, right? Because the window hierarchy was never created. So now, if you want to test the value inside a load name label, okay, abhi to UI application testing ki bhi hai. Initially, UI application testing was not there. Or suppose aapne view did load mein direct code likha hai without function. So kya karte aap? Aap zabardasti kya karte abhi? Load function banate. Aur usme sab dalte. Clear? So because of your test case, you drive to change your code. टेस्ट ड्रिवन प्रोग्राम क्लियर अगर मैं नॉर्मल कोड लिखता तो मैं तो फंक्शन बनाता ही नहीं चलो मैं नेम लेबल वहीं पे डाल दिया डाड़ 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 फिर टेस्ट केस लिखा पता चला टेस्ट कवर में तो वही नहीं मेरा कवर है ओके सपोज आई वांट नहीं नहीं मुझे ये यूआई टेस्टिंग में नहीं डालना है मुझे तो वापस इसमें ही डालना है लोड नेम लेबल तब क्या करोगे लोड एक और फंक्शन बनाओगे लोड नेम लेबल को कॉल करोगे लोड नेम लेवल में आपने क्या हार्ड कोड डाला है राइट जो वापस कंपेयर करते हैं क्लियर सो दिस वे यू हैव क्रिएटेड अ मॉड्यूलर कोड ओके नाउ आप बोलोगे नहीं नहीं लोड नेम लेवल में मैंने तो डायरेक्ट हार्ड कोड डाल दी है वैल्यू जीरो नहीं 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 मुझे पैरामीटराइज करनी है पड़ेगी कि मैं टेस्ट केसेस में थोड़ी ऐसे दिखूंगा जीरो है वो है
So you have been forced to create a load name label with a value as a parameter. Clear? Everyone? Now, we'll go to the UI test. UI test means basically binding of model and view, mostly towards the controller. Okay? In MVVM, you will say view model. Okay? Everyone? Now, here you see in setup, your application is launched. Okay? In your setup application, now यहाँ पे app delegate initialize होता है, create होता है, window hierarchy भी बनती है. Because here you are testing on a view, so that means you need a view hierarchy, right? It's a UI testing, right? So here you will compare the load name label. Here basically you will compare test only those functions where model and view meets. So here I won't be interested in get name. I'll be interested in load name label. Okay? So now here again I'll create a in setup So now here I'll say func test load name label. Again, I'll say let expected value equal to young, let actual value. Now to create an actual value, first I have to call this load function, right? So I'll say test controller dot load name label. Now I didn't have any parameter. मैंने zero वहाँ पे bypass किया हुआ है. Then I'll say let actual value equal to test controller dot name label dot text, right? So I'm comparing the value inside the so load namer will indirectly call the model binding, right? And then I'll say XC assert done. Shall I? So let's run this test suite. So I click here. I launch the app. So here
my test got successful, right? Everyone? Now your when you write this test case, you'll say I cannot test the input and output. You have done a hard coded work, right? So now you are driving to change the load name. You'll say value input karunga yahan se. Clear everyone? So now if I go to test coverage, you know, so yahan pe UI test aaya dega coverage mein. Main UI test dekhunga. Usme main view controller dekhunga. You see here, view did load got call. Now when UI test, the window hierarchy will get created. Compulsion hai. Normal unit test mein window hierarchy will never get created. Usne load name label bhi call kiya aur get name bhi thoda sa cover hua. Jo zero tak hi gaya na, wo yahan tak hi gaya. Ye log cover hi nahi kar paya. Everyone clear? So you can change the function to take a value and then you can do that way. Clear everyone? So test scenario, writing test case is the same as across all the platform. Android may be yahi tarika. Kali framework dalna hota hai aur test aise use karte hain.
Test controller
ye no, then button click से आप एक और function बनाओ. वो functions का लिखना पड़ेगा. Button click का या फिर आपको क्या करना है? Button click का जो function है ना, वो आपको call करना पड़ेगा. Test controller dot button click. वो display से होगा. So see, when this run was run, you want to see how much code was covered. Covered. So you will go to coverage. So ये वाला आपने run किया था अभी. So this one में दो files run हुई थी. View controller. तो view controller का आपने load name call किया था ना, तो वो 100% cover हुआ. But on a launch, the app also get launched in UI. In UI, so it's a view did load also got covered. The memory warning was never covered because there was no simulation only done. You can do a simulation of memory warning, right? उसके आसपास भी आप देख सकते हो. Okay, with my instruction, you will never get memory warning only. If you follow that instruction, view will appear and disappear. No chance.
Like view controller shifts
70%. 70% है, क्योंकि ये भी एक function cover नहीं हुआ ना, और ये भी 63% हुआ. इसपे मैं click करूँगा ना, तो बताएगा कि खाली इतना ही cover हुआ, ये लोग नहीं हुए थे. Obviously नहीं होगा, zero पे यहीं पे आगे बढ़ सकते हैं, ना? अभी यहाँ पे बोलेगा नहीं, आपको पूरा cover कराना, तो कैसे करोगे आप? You will run on a multiple test cases. Everyone clear? Shall I move ahead? Okay. Suppose